Morgan, Georgi Georgievich, the higher professor of the Aviation Institution and a candidate of for a degree of professor at the Institution of Aviation Sciences. Finished the mechanics and mathematics faculty in Kalmykia and was dealing with algorithms under the guidance of professor of physical and mathematics scientist Lubetsky. And next year he entered the mathematics and mechanics faculty where under the guidance of Mr. Lajansky, candidate of mathematical sciences Petrova, started studying history of mathematics. In parallel at the faculty of philology, he studied Sanskrit under the guidance of Cherkina and doctor of philological sciences Vinogradova, the student of Yuri Nikolaevich Rerich. In early 2010, he has been dealing with mathematics, physics, natural sciences at the institution of Vavilova at the Russian Academy of Sciences. From 2016 till 2018, Mr. Khmurkin has been working in the Moscow Technical University named after Bauman with seminars and lectures of higher mathematics. In 2018 till 2020, Mr. Khmurkin prepared for publications two books of Tibetologist, candidate of physical Theosophical Sciences, Kalachakra Tantra. And right now, for 3 years, the global community, Russian-speaking community, would like to mention this first publication of Kalachakra Tantra in the Russian language with the deciphration of Tibetan text. So Mr. Khmurkin is the only person who was helping and doing all possible in order for that to be possible. So thank you so much, in particular to you, Mr. Khmurkin, for that. So, Mr. Khmurkin, Georgi Georgievich, we would like to listen to your report.
The Cycles of Evolution in the Secret Doctrine by HPB and the Laws of Manu. My sincere greetings to all the participants of the Congress. Everyone who starts studying the secret doctrine faces an enormous quantity of terms about different cycles of evolution, Manvantara, Kalpa, Pralaya, the day of Brahma, the night of Brahma, etc. Most of them in the text of the secret doctrine are provided with definitions, minor, larger, sun, etc. Besides, while you're studying the text of Yelena Petrovna Blavatsky, you can see that sometimes she may call the same cycle with the different names, and vice versa. The same name may be applied to different cycles. There are two explanations to this fact. First of all, in the years when the secret doctrine was written, there was no precise system of definitions of terms, and that's why Elena Petrovna was in her, let's say, artistic search. And the second explanation, which I suppose is defines these reasons deeper, is the following. One of the basic principles of the secret doctrine is the principle of energy, so above as below, microcosm and microcosm. And when we try to describe some stages of the evolution of the systems, we find the similar stages in bigger systems. First, let's have a look at the life of a man, the period of activity, the light part of the day and night, when the activity is decreased. Let's say kalpa is the day and pralaya is the night. And the same we may compare it with the life of a man. The life is kalpa and existence between the lives is pralaya. And thus we can continue the same way. That's why for the same cycles, Елена Петровна Блаватская could use the same name, same terms. But it complicates the life of the reader, because in this free sea, free ocean of the words and terms, one has to find their path. And when I was a student, I set myself a task to understand what does Елена Петровна mean in every single case. This is my student coursework. These are quotes from the Secret Doctrine according to the cycles. They are grouped according to the themes, and I think I understood for myself what term can be applied to which cycle. And here in the several slides, I would like to show my conclusions. Here, you can see the first cycle, the period of one of the reign of one Manu. It's the length is 71 Mahayugas. I will tell a bit more about it later. The next term, the secret doctrine, is Sankhyas. That's from Sanskrit. What is Santis? There are 14 periods of the reign of one Manu, and if before them and in the end and between them we insert 15 small intervals, as a sum they will give us 6 Mahayugas. And this sum, this number of the small intervals, is called Sankhyas. Now, if we consider the period of reign of one Manu joined to one of these 15 intervals, we will have a one planetary circle, which length is 71.4 Mahayugas. And we see that planetary pralaya corresponds to it, with the same length as the planetary circle. Then we see the day of Brahma, 7 planetary rounds, plus 7 planetary pralayas, plus one small eddy as one Satya Yuga. Here we see the night of Brahma corresponding to this length. Then there is a year of Brahma, which means 360 days and 360 nights. The century of Brahma, 100 years. And the last cycle is Maha Pralaya. It's the cycle of the absence of any action, but its length is the same as the century of Brahma. One difficulty that I faced as a student was a difficulty connected to the cycle of Mahayuga. From the secret doctrine, we know that Mahayuga consists of four smaller cycles. Sub-cycles, Krita Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, and Kali Yuga. They have proportions and lengths defined. But in the Secret Doctrine, there is one interesting quote. Here is one problematic place that I would like to talk about. The interval that precedes each yuga is called Sankhya and composed of as many hundreds of years as there are thousands in the yuga. and that which follows the latter is named Sandhyamsa and is of similar duration. The interval between the Sandhya and the Sandhyamsa is the Yuga. This place, or just the mentioning Sandhya and Sandhyamsa in the secret doctrine, there are very few mentioning of this, and we don't know how to insert them in the system of yugas. Where are they in Mahayuga? That's why I had to refer to the Indian text, which is mentioned many times in the sacred doctrine. This is the sacred Indian text, the Laws of Manu by name. Its content is estimated for more than 200 years. It is written in Sanskrit, ancient Indian language, and its structure is composed of 12 chapters where we find information about the duty of Brahman, Kshatriya, about the structure of the Indian society. There is a series of themes for 5,500 lines. This is the example, 5,500 lines like that. And the first chapter is telling about the evolution of cosmos, the periodical births and destructions of the universe, several cycles are mentioned. So I concentrated my efforts on the first chapter, which tells about these issues. And here there are several stanzas, several lines that I would like to show you, and in order to solve the mystery of Sandhya and Sandhyamsa. Here you see the chapter 1, stanza 69. I will just read one stanza so that you may hear it in Sanskrit. Varyahu sahasrani varshanam tatkurtam yugam tasyata vachati sandhya sandhyam shashchatadhavidha. The translation is as following. It is said that this Kriya Yuga is a period of 4,000 divine years. The Sandhya and Sandhyamsa contain as many hundreds of divine years as the period of millennia. So we see that Kriya Yuga from Sandhya Sandhyamsa is different by 10,000 times, yet we do not understand whether it is included in Kriya Yuga or not. Next stanza, chapter 1, and in other three yugas, as well as in Sandhya and Sandhyamsa, the number of thousand and accordingly the number of hundreds of years decreases each time by one. Thus we know that these yugas, the Treta Yuga, is associated with the period of 3,000 divine years, the Dvapara Yuga is associated with the period of 2,000 years, and Kali Yuga is associated with the period of 1,000 divine years. If we put them all together, we will have 10,000 years. So it seems clear, yet all four yugas gives us 10,000 years. Yet the last stanza destroys this logic completely. Here we may find information that the four yugas listed as in the beginning have a total duration of 12,000 divine years, which are called the divine yuga. So the author of the Manu Laws summed up these durations, but he didn't get the result of 10,000, but 12,000. From this, you make a conclusion that Sandhya and Sandhyamsa, in fact, just add these 3, 4, 3, 2, and 1,000 years. And after some easy mathematic research, we may come to the next conclusion, which is that the whole yuga, any of the four yugas, is divided into three parts. The first part is Sandhya, which is 1/12 of the total duration of the yuga. The next part is yuga itself. And the third one is Sandhyamsa, which is also 1/12 of total yoga duration. The result of this work is a table. Here I give it in Russian. I will show it in English a bit later. You see Maha Yuga, which is divided in four yugas. This is a known fact, but not very known fact is that every yuga is divided into three parts. Santhya of this yuga, the yuga itself, and Santhyamsha of the yuga. And the same happens for every yuga. This initial and final parts of the yuga are 10,000 times shorter than the medium part, which is the longest one. Here is the English version. You may get acquainted with it. Thank you for your attention. Thank you very much. Mr. Kmurkin, our applause to you. Excuse me, could you please repeat what is the translation of Santhya and Santhyamsha? Sorry, I didn't mention the translation. Santhya from Sanskrit means the dawn. Oh, I'm sorry, the twilight. And Santhyamsha, it's Samdhya and Amsha, which means a part of twilight. Why I ask this question? Before your translation, when we were talking about it, I'm sorry, this is just a scientific symposium, maybe we talk about the subjects. I had a thought where these two came from and why they provide us the sum. And there is a third part. What is the idea? If we take the method according to the planes of being and see these yugas as they have to evolve according to the one law verbalized by Helena Petrovna Blavatsky, the one, the beginning, and the dense state of the yoga, and the finalizing. These two points, which are the beginning of twilight and the end of twilight, they are this satya or nirvana for every yoga, the state of nirvana for every yoga. And this is an esoteric moment. That's why in the text of the laws of Manas that you quote, there are 10,000 is an exoteric number, the physical number, let's put it like that. But 12,000 is esoteric number because satya is always hidden and it is always short. It is the total dawn, nirvana, the bliss. So it is the return to the inner state. Basically, you reveal the inner state necessary for the beginning and the end of the cycle. This is my revelation just now. Thank you for that, for your insight. Yes, thank you very much for your ideas, for your thought. Mr. Kmurkin, your reports undoubtedly raise great interest among the entire world community. The research and originality of scientific discoveries in the synthesis of the analysis of the Sanskrit terminology, especially such a complicated topic as the secret doctrine, as cycles, are of great importance. I think that Russian foreign scientists and theosophists will return to a report more than once and study it. Thank you very much separately for the recognition that contemporary academic research in the field of the cycles of evolution are not enough and it can be seen in the Book of Zion. Thank you very much.